LGR 103.3 FM.
Hello.
Hi there.
Hello.
Good evening, everyone. You're listening to NEPOMAK UK live on LGR. I'm Antonia.
I am Antonis.
And I'm Andreas.
And if you tuned into our last show, you know a little bit about who we are. So what is NEPOMAK? We are the World Organization of Overseas Cypriots. We have 8 member branches across the world, from Canada, the US, Australia, South Africa. And we run a host of programs aimed at promoting Cypriot heritage and culture and bringing Cypriots across the world together.
Also tonight, a very, very special treat. We have a special guest speaker. If you can guess who it is, we'll give you a little clue. That's right, it's not Simon Cowell, you guessed it, it's Laki from the dynamic duo of Stavros Flatley.
Hello everybody.
Thanks for coming, Laki, great to have you with us.
Thank you very much for having me.
Cool, our pleasure. I'm sure everyone's going to want to hear us ask you loads and loads of questions. We're going to ask you stuff about Britain's Got Talent and general life, and about being a British born Cypriot and having loads of good food in your life.
Before we carry on with the show, just a couple of quick announcements about what we've been up to and what's coming up in the Cypriot community. So, Andrea, do you want to start by telling us about the Rally for Cyprus?
Yes, we've got an important event coming up. It's the annual Rally for Cyprus. This year, it's going to be on the 17th of July, and that's a Sunday. And at 3 p.m. outside Belgrave Square, London, SW1, everyone's going to congregate together and then begin our march bound to Trafalgar Square. And the nearest stations will be Hyde Park Corner and Victoria. Why do we do these marches? Well, Cyprus needs our support. We know the situation with our country. You don't have to be politically active to come along to show your support. It's a great way to be there to say, look, I don't forget about my country. I'm here to show that I still care about it.
Yeah, and it's really important with the young community as well, isn't it, Andrea?
Yes, because we do need a lot more young people to come. And that's part of the reason that we're here, to get the young people supporting and coming to our rallies.
So we'll see everyone down there, hopefully.
Yep. Cool.
And I'm just going to briefly mention about the wine festival that we were at last weekend? No, Saturday the 25th and Sunday the 26th of June at Alexandra Palace.
I don't know, I was still half asleep and hungover on that day. I don't remember
the day. Yep, the Cyprus wine was quite good that day.
Yeah, it was hosted by Bariagi, Cypriot newspaper, if you don't know. And it was great fun. The business exhibition had a lot of successful businesses of the Cypriot community, including banks, airlines, state agents. I don't need to bore you with the details. It was opened by President Christofias.
Ooh.
Which was nice. And we also had awesome performances from Gligeria and Charbel. So thank you for everyone who paid our store visit and signed up. And check the YouTube video from the wine festival weekend.
Yeah, that was pretty cool. We got a lot of footage on that. Thanks to Andonia.
Thanks. But I was there on the Sunday. I was there on the Saturday. And that was quite busy. Was it?
Yeah, Andonia, on the Sunday was pretty cool as well. Because Charbel there on the Saturday?
I think he was on both days.
On Sunday, so obviously a lot of people came to see him. Ligeria before that. Ligeria, I mean, she's aged a bit now, but she's still got it. She looks good. Yeah, it was cool. It was good. Both days were good, wasn't
she's
it?
She's got a beautiful voice as well.
She does. Timeless classics.
Great. And on that note, we're going to finish with a song by Charbel.
Καλοκαίρι μπροστά μας, νησιά, πάρτι, ακρογιαλιές. Εκεί θα χτυπάει η καρδιά μας, εκεί σ' αγαπώ θα μου λες. Υπάρχεις για μένα, στο σώμα μου περνά. Ακόμα ένα φίλι στο σώμα, να πιω, να ξενυχτήσω και να γίνω λιώμα. Να ονειρεύομαι μες στο πόδι σου. Ακόμα ένα φίλι στο στόμα, να πιω, να ξενυχτήσω και να γίνω λιώμα. Ακόμα ένα γλυκό φίλι σου, να ζω, να ονειρεύομαι, να λέω σ' αγαπώ.
καλοκαίρι μπροστά μας. Στο φως του Αιγαίου θα σε βρω. Μια θάλασσα η αγκαλιά μας. Με θέλει, σε θέλω κι εγώ. Υπάρχεις για μένα, στο σώμα μου περνά. Ακόμα ένα φίλι στο σώμα. Να πιω, να ξενυχτήσω και να γίνω λιώμα. Ακόμα ένα γλυκό φίλι σου. Να ζω, να ονειρεύομαι μες στο πορμί σου. Ακόμα ένα φίλι στο σώμα. Να πιω, να ξενυχτήσω και να γίνω λιώμα. Ακόμα ένα γλυκό φίλι σου. Να ζω, να ονειρεύομαι, να λέω σ' αγαπώ. Μαζί σου τον κόσμο να αλλάξω μπορώ. Αστέρι καυτό καλοκαίρι. Ακόμα ένα φίλι στο σώμα. Να πιω, να ξενυχτήσω και να γίνω λιώμα. Ακόμα ένα γλυκό φίλι σου. Να ζω, να ονειρεύομαι μες στο κορμί σου. Ακόμα ένα φίλι στο σώμα. Να πιω, να ξενυχτήσω και να γίνω λιώμα. Ακόμα ένα γλυκό φίλι σου. Να ζω, να ονειρεύομαι, να λέω σ' αγαπώ.
LGR 103,3 στα FM. Τραγουδάει ελληνικά. LGR.
Want to know the latest in London? Check out lgr.co.uk.
Little Leo's Nursery, based in New Southgate, are celebrating 4 years this year, offering a high-quality, all-round nursery care to children from the age of 3 months to 5 years. Every child's day is carefully planned to make sure they receive the best experience that is rich in care and education, whilst meeting individual social, physical and emotional needs. To discuss availability, call Athena Gugudas on 0208 211 3119.
Ένα και μοναδικό.
You are tuned into LGR 103.3 FM.
So, welcome back to NEPOMAK on LGR, and you're live here with myself, Andreas.
Antonia.
And Donis.
I'd just like to point out, I've just noticed something. All of your names begin with A, yeah?
Yeah.
So, I'm going to officially dub you as the A team.
Whoa.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Who's Mr. T?
Beautiful.
I ain't getting on plane.
I think Andreas should be Murdoch.
Oh.
Is that all right?
Yeah, that's perfect. Okay. People call me that already.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, that's cool. Best looking as well, you want.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my
goodness.
All
right, now we're back on with Laki. Let's not waste any more of your precious, precious time, because I know you've got loads of dancing to do after.
Oh, yeah,
right, let's hit him with some questions. Don't be easy on him.
All right.
I've got a question for Laki.
Cool.
Okay, this whole, your performance, whose idea was it? Where did it come from?
Well, about 10 years ago, my dad had a restaurant in Oakwood called the Sitagi, and he used to... This was when Michael Flatley was huge, you know, and he was doing Lord of the Dance and all this. So my dad decided what would be funnier than a short fat bloke doing Michael Flatley and some women's jogging bottoms with a huge weightlifting belt tied up so tight. And yeah, and the first time he done it, he pulled the hairdresser in from next door, sat him down and said, right, watch this. So he ran out, put the music on, and all of a sudden he's come flying in with his wig on, and he said the hairdresser was lying on the floor laughing. So since then it's just been a big thing. And then my dad said, do you want to go on Brindle Town and do it as a joke? And I said, yeah, go for it. So yeah.
Wicked,
that's what happened.
And how did you personally find the experience and going on Britain's Got Talent?
It wasn't, it was the best thing I've ever done, if I'm honest. I mean, it was all a joke to begin with, and it still is just a silly little dance that we do. You can't take yourself really seriously when you're doing stuff like this, and it's just something good to do with my dad and stuff like that, so it's really good.
Who was the most famous person you've ever met that you enjoyed?
Right, well, to me, the most famous person we've ever met was Michael Flatley, because that's where the whole...
The Riverdance,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, the whole act revolves around, you know, like, he's so cocky with the ladies. He's full too chubby.
Is that where you get it from?
Exactly. Running up to a woman, pointing at her, kissing your bicep, and pointing off in the air is just the best thing. But Simon Cowell's, you know, got to be, like, up there. I mean, he's been, like, a mentor for us, and he's done so much for us. As, you know, we danced at his birthday, so that was amazing. They were all in white immaculate suits, and we just rocked up, done our dance in these little short trousers, black trousers with two Diet Cokes in our hands. And
did you tell Michael Flatley that his dance originally is Greek?
Oh, of course.
Did he know that?
That was before my dad even shook his hand. He went, "Listen, you should be paying Greeks for royalties for
there
that."
There you go.
And my dad's got a theory that many years ago, Stavros Dinodopoulos was his great was Michael Flatley's great descendant of Riverdance, and that's where it all started. So
could very well be.
And what was your best moment on Britain's Got Talent?
Best moment had to be when we found out we were through to the final, because the semi-final was probably the most nerve-wracking, because we all knew, you know, we don't want to sound cocky or big-headed, but everyone there knew they were good acts that year, and we it was only the nerve-wracking time, because we knew if we got to the final it would just be a huge, you know, blowout, like,
yeah,
best.
Sure.
Yeah,
it's just a big laugh, and you know, and if you know, when you got through to semi-final, it means you got to go on tour and everything. And I got to, you know, we met some great friends, made some great friends. Diversity, I still talk to all the boys, and George Sampson, little Aiden, the body popper.
Yeah,
taught me some moves, you know. And yeah, I taught him some moves as well. I have to say, old chainsaw and everything. And other than that, it's just been really good.
Cool. I actually want to know a more important question, right? I know the other day you were showing me videos, and you was backstage, and you had like a camera crew, and there was like all these girls jumping on you.
Oh yeah.
It was just honestly, it was loads, guys. It was loads. Yeah, it was full of them. And they wanted to marry you, apparently. On that night, how many numbers did you get? How many, honestly? In fact, no, don't answer, because you're gonna make me and Andrea look bad. On a serious note, do you have a girlfriend?
Well, there is one special woman in my life.
Okay, yeah, what's her name?
See, I can't tell you because we're live on air. If my husband finds out, he'll kill me.
Husband, not just boyfriend.
No, no, no. If you're gonna do it properly.
Oh wow.
So yeah.
And then third, did you have another question?
Well, we've mentioned about Simon Cowell. Who was your favourite judge?
Oh, I've got to say Amanda.
Well, because she's the best looking.
Oh yeah, definitely. And plus, you know, she's always been there for us, and she's always helped us. Even this year, you know, she mentioned us on the show, and that's just helped us so much. And we went to one of her. We dance for a friend's charity and stuff like that. So
she actually picked you guys to win, didn't she?
Yeah, she put us in the envelope.
In the envelope. Yeah.
God, I nearly cried. Amazing. Yeah.
That's brilliant.
And I've got friends called Bavlo, who's an aspiring bouzouki player. A few of you listeners might know him. And he wants to go on Britain's Got Talent one day.
Okay.
What advice would you give to him?
You know, with the bouzouki, it's such an amazing thing. So many Greeks want to know how to play a bouzouki. So I'm sure you've got all the Greek community on your side, you know, whatever you do. And yeah, I did play the bouzouki for a bit, and you have to make sure that you strap your fingers up, because that really hurts. I heard Andreas plays the bit, you know, I've been learning for a bit.
I've been learning for a couple of weeks now, and already my fingers, the tips of them fly, cut off. So I can see exactly what you're talking about there.
Yeah, but, you know, just take it as a joke, and if they say no, it's not because, you know, of anything personal. It's just, it's not right, but I'm sure, you know, I'll have everyone rooting for him, and I'll make sure I'll be rooting for him all the way.
Well, I know there's a couple of Greek acts tried to get onto Britain's Got Talent.
We found out there was a father and son doing the dacha this year, man.
Yeah.
I thought that'd been wicked.
Have you got any advice to give him? Because obviously, I think personally, what made you guys so great is that you didn't go on and do just like a Greek show. You've done something different.
Yeah, well, it's always good to add a bit of the twist. You know, a year ago, 2 years ago, there was the year before us. Remember Signature?
Yeah.
Well, that was you know, the twist is always
wicked,
good.
Yeah,
really
the twist.
Good.
And it's just, you know, be surprising, you know, don't just be, you know, don't let them read a book by its cover, you know, just surprise them.
And tell us about your relationship with your dad, because you seemed really close on the show.
Yeah, I'll go back to my real family later. My dad, you know, my relationship with my dad, I can see him laughing in the office. My relationship with my dad is just, it's amazing. Oh, he told me that joke he's telling me now. My relationship with my dad is just amazing. On Father's Day, you know, we did ring up the son, you know, and we have some friends who's like columnists, so we rang him up and I said, what can I get him for his for Father's Day present? So he said, well, how about I write you a column up? And it was on the news and it was on the internet and everything. So yeah, it was really good. And you know, it's been amazing. I've got to know him a bit more in these last years, but I just realised, you know, one important thing is I need to get him a joke book. So I think I've heard all of his material in the last 2 years. I mean, the car can get pretty lonely, but then he pulls out one of his old jokes, and yeah, it's been really good though.
Have you got any tips, right, for people? I know, because people think it's easy. It's not actually easy getting a belly, like a proper belly, a Greek belly.
Oh, Andreas is...
I'm getting there,
Andreas. We're on the radio, so you can't see him. He's giving a good rub on his belly.
Yeah, quite hairy as well.
Well, I'm Greek, what do you expect?
Put it away.
Oh, man. What can I say? It's just loads of souvla, and then chicken souvla. And lamb souvlaki.
Can you make a souvlaki now?
Oh yeah, my dad's taught me how to make a mean souvlaki.
Yeah.
But he doesn't let me skewer the meat because he says me and a skewer just don't go. So it's dangerous. Yeah, so it's you gotta eat, and you know, eat everything that you want. And, you know, just live life.
Wicked.
Thanks, Laki. We'll be back with you in a second. We're just gonna play a quick song.
Thank you, guys.
For Irini in Southgate.
Αλήθεια ή ψέμα, το όνειρο το είδα. Μοιραίο για μένα το βλέμμα αυτό. Αλήθεια ή ψέμα, τα μάτια σου παγίδα. Μοιραίο για μένα να σ' αγαπώ. Είναι ο τρόπος που κοιτάζεις και έτσι απλά με επηρεάζεις. Είναι ο τρόπος που κοιτάζεις και τον έχεις μόνο εσύ. Ένα βλέμμα σου μονάχα και στον ουρανό με φτάνεις. Άλλη μια καρδιά και νάχα θα στην Εδίνα, γιατί το φωνάζω. Με καμία δε σ' αλλάζω. Σ' αγαπάω στο φωνάζω. Στην καρδιά μου είσαι εσύ. Μία και μοναδική. Αλήθεια ή ψέμα, κι εγώ δεν το ελέγχω. Πιο πάνω από μένα η αγάπη αυτή. Αλήθεια ή ψέμα, άλλη φορά δεν έχω. Έτσι όπως εσένα ερωτευτή. Είναι ο τρόπος που κοιτάζεις και έτσι απλά με επηρεάζεις. Είναι ο τρόπος που κοιτάζεις και τον έχεις μόνο εσύ. Ένα βλέμμα σου μονάχα και στον ουρανό με φτάνεις. Άλλη μια καρδιά και νάχα θα στην Εδίνα, γιατί το φωνάζω. Με καμία δε σ' αλλάζω. Σ' αγαπάω στο φωνάζω. Στην καρδιά μου είσαι εσύ. Μία και μόνα δυνάζω. Με καμία δε σ' αλλάζω. Σ' αγαπάω στο φωνάζω. Στην καρδιά μου είσαι εσύ. Μία και μοναδική.
Σ' αγαπάω στο φωνάζω. Στην καρδιά μου είσαι εσύ, μία και μοναδική.
LGR με ρυθμό ελληνικό. LGR.
With the A team, and of course, Laki's still here.
Welcome back, guys. Laki, we have some shout outs. Do you want to do the honours of reading them out for us?
Right, the first one is Steph Cipressa.
Cipressa.
And he would give me like to have a shout out to all of the other Gunes.
That's Gunes.
Yeah, Gunes. Oh. Gunes.
He can never pronounce it right.
Always Gunes.
Oh, come on, man. Come on, Arsenal.
No, well, I'm a hammer myself. So.
Yeah, the ones who bribe for stadiums.
Subject, guys.
There's another one to Mr. Chris Greco El Bizzle.
El Bizzelli.
Bizzelli. I keep saying Bizzle.
That's the Greek lethal.
Yeah. And Peter Sideburns. That's not. Yeah. And my reading's shocking. And there's another one from Marula Stavrula Papa Constantides.
That's a no mouthful, way. Man.
God, man. And she bet 10 Cypriot pounds that nobody has a longer Cypriot name than she does.
She's proud clever, you know Greek. Why? There's no more Cypriot pounds.
That's very true, but I think I can beat that.
Go on, Laki.
My sister's name is Elisia Constantino Vasilou Dimitriou.
Oh my goodness, that is long.
Come on, that is good.
Oh, they do say you know you're Greek Cypriot when your last name consists of the entire alphabet.
That's very true.
Let's ask Laki a few more questions. People are dying to know more about him.
I want to know about any funny experiences that you've had.
There's
any
a few.
Anytime.
Right, I fell off the stage once. Ooh. I was sort of falling, and then I looked down and I was like, yeah, you're going to catch me to the crowd. They just sort of went, yeah, and they just sort of shuffled out of the way. And I was like, oh, come on. And I sort of just face planted. Another time my wig got stuck on my head because I had hair gel in, and the hair gel sort of moulded to the wig, and I tried pulling it off and I pulled off like a clump of my own hair. I don't want to be yeah.
Yeah, at least you still got hair.
And oh god, what else? I threw my wig once and it hit someone and I was like, oh sorry. Turned back around and I saw this blonde thing coming straight back at me. Now I know what it feels like to have the wig dashed at you. So yeah, that's just a few of them.
You weren't so happy getting the wig.
No.
You should
have
put your underwear.
Oh, I've had the more positive response.
So we go back on the subject of Gilias.
Okay, right.
Are you considering getting a tattoo like your dad when you're old enough?
Oh, I tell you what, my dad was telling me the other day, he's the only man in the world with the Cypriot tattoo on his belly. Yeah, what? So he's been telling me that, but I don't know, maybe I could be the second. I don't know.
Is it seriously? If anyone else has a Cypriot tattoo,
yeah.
Text us in, yeah. Let us know. Like, he'll come sort you out.
Yeah. I don't think my dad would be very happy about that, but I have to clarify, he is the only man in the world with it on his belly. So if anyone else has one, just text in and tell us. But you will make my dad very disappointed.
I'm sure some crazy fans might have gone and got a similar one done after they've seen you on the show.
You never know, someone could hear it here and run out and get one and be like, oh, I'm the second.
I know someone who drew it on with a permanent marker as well once.
Oh,
yeah, there must have been loads of them. what was it like when you went back to school? That must have been crazy.
Oh, that was a good time. That was like when I was, because my primary school's right next to my secondary school, so I knew everyone anyway. But then when I came back, like, everyone was just walking past going, hey, it's Mini Stavros. I'm like, you know my name. But like, it's been Mini Stavros since then. And like, when substitute teachers come in, my friends are like, do you know this is? And I'm like, no, guys. And they're like, no, it's Mini Stavros. Like, she's like, oh my god. And yeah, that's a good thing.
Did they ask you to do a dance?
Yeah, we've done it for our school, I think twice now, and they've just been really helpful and supportive to us, and just give me all the time of school that, you know, we need, and just been really good.
Awesome. And speaking of school, did you ever go to Greek school like all of us were forced to?
Tell me you got out of it.
I managed to worm my way out of it, you know.
How did you do it?
I don't know, but when I got to like the age of about 10, we started getting tutors and stuff like that. And I was really up for it, but then our Stavros took off. And but we're lucky now in our school. We do Greek and as one of the GCSEs anyway, so it's all good. Yeah.
Well, I used to be ill every single Saturday.
Every single Saturday.
Yeah, the Saturday yeah. Back we school.
Except when you used to go and do the dancing at Greek school, then you're all right.
Yeah.
Once you're live and kicking, then
it was the live and kicking days.
And is your favourite film My Big Fat Greek Wedding?
Oh, that is so true, isn't it? My dad watched that and he was like, oh my god, some of the things in there is so true, like, you know, with the Easter Christo Nesti and everything, and the Windex. We use Zivania, but
Zivania's for everything.
It's the cure for everything.
I remember my ear would get me to bathe in that if she could, like, you know, after football. Oh, my ear, my legs are aching. Oh, let me get the Zivania. I'm not gonna have a drink. No, it's rub on you. Oh, okay.
I'll tell you what, you're lucky. You're lucky. Have you heard of Venduzes?
No, what's that?
Right, that's some serious Zivania stuff, right? They get these, like, they're like shot glasses, basically. I'll try and explain really basic. They get like a match and some cotton wool. They dip it in the Zivania and they light it on fire. Yeah. Then they place it on your back.
Oh, and
then you're left
God.
With these big red round rings on your back.
Oh, my God.
And it cures everything.
That's like in that's like in the Karate Kid film. Have you seen that?
Yeah.
Everything comes from the Greeks.
Everything comes from the Greeks.
We've said it here. Everything does come from Cyprus.
The worst one I've heard is my dad told me about the ear hair, where the barbers used to get the match and just flip it. I was like, I wish I never have ear hair for that reason.
What's another one we use a lot? It must be olive oil.
Oh, my dad says there's nothing better than having a little bit of olive oil everywhere, and I'm like, oh, what, on the salad? He's like, yeah, on the souvlaki, yeah.
I'm
like, okay.
On the hair, on the scalp.
Yeah.
Moisturiser. Yeah.
Once again, it works.
Oh, my mum used to suntan with olive oil, and I was like, mum, you're gonna cook.
We had the funny one when I was a kid. Was wrestling my brother, as you do when you're kids.
Oh yeah.
And he lifted me up in there and he dropped me, and as I dropped, I cracked my head on the table.
Oh my God.
Cracked open. There was blood everywhere. Obviously, my eyes were there, screaming. My mum was screaming. So my AI had the brilliant idea to get Greek coffee and pour the whole tub over my head. Over my head, and then the doctor turns up to stitch up. He's like, what's happened?
He's got third degree burns on his head.
I can't stitch him up now because he's got coffee everywhere.
Oh man, don't tell my ear about that one.
We've got some texts, some people are texting some interesting things in actually, about on the theme of, you know, you're a British born Cypriot when. We've got some really good ones. Hang on. You know you're a British born Cypriot when your cheeks receive their weekly workout every time you visit an aunt. Laki, is that the case with your family also?
Oh. That is pretty very much the case in my family. I have to admit that one. There's another one on here that I like. Is you go to a wedding and take a fancy to one of the guests. Later, you discover that the guest is someone you're related to.
Oh my God!
Yeah,
I can have to say that's never happened to me.
I've got to say that is so true.
Andreas, speaking from experience here.
No comment.
It's fine. Fourth cousins don't count. It's fine.
And what else have we got? There's quite a few good ones actually. Have you ever been hit with a bandoffler?
What's that?
Oh, a slipper.
A slipper. Oh right, My eye used to favour the slipper. You know, just round the back of the ear is a good one. And my eye used to do the bimbi as well.
The bimbi.
Yeah, she used to have a bimbi on her shirt. Just used to touch it when we were bad. We just stop. Never once did she ever take it off her shirt. Right. And whenever she looked at it, we just stopped.
Yeah, mine was the skin law is gonna come.
We had the Zonny, plain and simple.
Oh God.
That's why at Greek school everyone behaves themselves. Where English school, all the kids are out of control.
Yeah, you get
classes.
A slipper thrown at you in Greek school.
No, we were scared that you'd get hit with a bastoni if you went out of line at Greek school. Yeah, by the priest.
Let me ask you guys a question. What about this one? You know you're Greek. Whenever you first meet another Greek, you always ask what village they're from.
Yeah, that is true.
My dad always said, what village are you from? Not even hello. What village are you from? From Augusta. Oh my God.
Yeah, then you pretend you know where it is.
And I'm like, oh yeah.
And if it's the same village, you probably find out you are related.
Yeah.
Or you knew each other from before.
And we're probably all related down the line.
Oh yeah. Somewhere down the line.
And what else? There's quite a few. Andrea, is there any you like?
Where's the list gone? It's gone somewhere.
Here. Have a look.
Oh, this one. you've ever broken one of those porcelain figurines and your mother or Yaya still hasn't forgiven you for it.
Oh, yeah. There was a forbidden cabinet in my Yaya's house. Never, we could never touch it. My sister was found once opening it. Oh, God, my mum had to Oh, my God, that wasn't a very good day. That was... My Yaya's never forgetting my little sister for even looking at that cabinet.
What was in the cabinet?
Oh, you know, the old crystal little glasses that no one ever used.
That you never used, yeah.
Yeah, you'd spend all that money on these little crystal... like.
Just to have them in the cupboard, yeah.
And the special little gaffer glass, like, cups, like, what are they for? If they're just to look
at
you.
Have any to use, and you don't want to use it.
And it's funny, because even if they said you're not allowed to touch that cupboard, you wouldn't go near it, you wouldn't pay the blind bit of notice, but because it's the forbidden cupboard,
yeah,
and they said, don't go near it, you want to go, yeah, exactly.
I think I remember asking a few people on this one, what was the number one? And a couple of them was, I think one of the best ones I liked was, you say to your mum, like, I'm not hungry, I don't want to eat, just put me a little bit. And she still puts you the whole, like the whole pot. And she thinks, what's wrong with you? Are you ill?
Like, you don't eat all of it, yeah.
That's one way of getting your GIA, isn't it?
You must be ill if you're not eating.
That actually reminds me of my Yaya's favourite line is whenever we go to her house and she always puts like a whole chicken in front of me and I'm supposed to eat it all. And if I don't eat it all, I won't marry a tall, good looking husband.
So you didn't eat much of it?
Oh, cheers, Antonia. I've still got a few years left. Yet. Oh, gosh. Well, thank you so much for listening. I think, are we nearly out of time? God, that's gone quickly.
Has it? Oh, God. I think the news was very long when we started, but.
Oh, yeah, Dad. Hello.
Your Ferry's here to take you home.
Oh, have I got to bed? Is it past your bedtime?
Yeah, past your bedtime.
Oh, no, Mr. Stavros is here.
First foot down.
Time for home, otherwise his mother will kill him.
Oh, as you just heard, my mum will kill me if I'm late, and I've got dinner on the table. So thank you very much, guys, for having me today.
No, thank you.
Thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you very much, guys. Anytime you want me back to have a little bit of a laugh, you know. Oh, you've all got my number, so thank you very much.
Yeah, definitely.
Guys.
Thanks. Thank you very much, Laki.
I could ask one favour.
Of course.
You couldn't play the Galamathiano for me, could you? Nahariz.
We could do. Nahariz.
Yeah, we could play that.
Could you?
I'd love you forever if you played that for me.
No problem. We'll get that on for you now. And for the rest of everyone listening in, thanks for tuning in. You've been listening to NEPOMAK on LGR.
Don't forget the rally.
Don't forget the rally. We want to see you there. Supporting Cyprus. Laki, will you be there?
Of course I'll be there. If we're not, we'll be there spiritually, you know, helping as much as we can.
Perfect.
And you can follow us on Facebook, NEPOMAK UK. You can follow us on Twitter as well.
More importantly, just sign up today, NEPOMAK, www.nepomak.org. Sign up to keep in the loop with our upcoming events and news. Thanks for listening, guys.
Thank you from the A-Team and Mr. Laki.
Good night.
Bye. Σου. Χίνει φωτιά,
Χέρια που πνίγουν, πόδια δέρια που με τυλίγουν, φωνή γλυκιά που στάζει μέλη κι ας τραγουδά πως δεν με θέλει. Να χαρείς, να χαρείς, να χαρείς τα μάτια σου. Δεν αντέχω να πεθαίνω μπροστά σκαλοπάτια σου. Να χαρείς, να χαρείς, να χαρείς τα μάτια σου. Δεν αντέχω να πεθαίνω μπροστά σκαλοπάτια σου. Δεν αντέχω να πεθαίνω μπροστά σκαλοπάτια σου. Να χαρείς, να χαρείς, να χαρείς τα μάτια σου. Δεν αντέχω να πεθαίνω μπροστά σκαλοπάτια σου. Δεν αντέχω να πεθαίνω μπροστά σκαλοπάτια σου.